Hello everyone. Today I'm going to give you a brief overview of online certificate status protocol stapling for server certificates in AWS IoT Core. AWS IoT Core, a managed cloud service that lets customers securely connect Internet of Things or IoT devices to the cloud and manage them at scale, supports online certificate status protocol or OCSP stapling for server certificates. This security feature adds an extra layer of verification to check the validity and revocation status of your custom domain server certificate in a transport layer security or TLS handshake. When your device or other client attempts to connect to AWS IoT Core, the AWS IoT Core server will send an X.509 certificate that your device uses to authenticate the server. Authentication takes place at the TLS layer through validation of the certificate chain. This is the same method used by your browser when you visit an HTTPS URL. One way to check if a certificate is valid is by using OCSP. It allows real-time validation of SSL TLS certificates during the secure handshake process. It checks if the certificate hasn't expired or been revoked by the issuing certificate authority since it was issued. OCSP is more efficient and scalable compared to traditional certificate revocation lists or CRLs. OCSP responses are smaller in size, making them suitable for large private key infrastructures or PKIs with many certificates. There are two main ways OCSP can be used. One, client-side OCSP. In this mode, during the TLS handshake, the client contacts an OCSP responder to verify the revocation status of the server's certificate. An OCSP responder, also known as OCSP server, receives and responds to OCSP requests from clients that seek to verify the revocation status of certificates. The second option, server-side OCSP or OCSP stapling. Here, the server is enabled to make the request to the OCSP responder. It then staples or attaches the OCSP response to the certificate and sends it to the client during the TLS handshake. There are a few advantages of using server certificate OCSP stapling compared to client-side OCSP checks. Without OCSP stapling, client devices can expose information to third-party OCSP responders when checking certificate revocation status, potentially compromising user privacy. OCSP stapling mitigates this by having the server obtain the OCSP response and deliver it directly to the client. It also can improve reliability as the server periodically fetches and caches OCSP responses, reducing reliance on real-time OCSP responder availability. Additionally, OCSP stapling offloads the burden of responding to OCSP requests from responders to the server, distributing load more evenly and making certificate validation more efficient and scalable. Finally, it reduces latency by attaching the OCSP response with the server certificate during the TLS handshake instead of the client querying the OCSP server separately. How does OCSP stapling work in AWS IoT Core? With OCSP stapling enabled for your custom domain in AWS IoT Core, the service calls an OCSP responder every hour to get the certificate's revocation status. It then caches the latest valid OCSP response. During a TLS handshake, AWS IoT Core retrieves this cached response and includes it along with the server certificate sent to the client device. The device can then validate the certificate status using the stapled OCSP response. Let's look at the step-by-step workflow. First, the device needs to be registered with custom domains with OCSP stapling enabled. Two, AWS IoT Core calls OCSP responder every hour to get the certificate status. Three, the OCSP responder receives the request, sends the latest OCSP response, and the server stores the cached OCSP response. Four, the device sends a client hello message to initiate the TLS handshake with AWS IoT Core. Five, AWS IoT Core gets the latest OCSP response from the server cache. 6. The server sends a server hello message to the device. The server also sends the server certificate and the certificate status to the client. 7. The device validates the OCSP server status. And finally, 8, the TLS handshake is completed. Let's go over the steps on how to enable OCSP stapling. To enable this feature in AWS IoT Core, you must create a domain configuration for a custom domain or update an existing custom domain configuration. This can be done using AWS IoT Console or command line interface. I'll show you how to do this from the console. From the AWS console, navigate to AWS IoT Core. Choose Settings from the left navigation menu. Then choose Create Domain Configuration or an existing domain configuration for a custom domain. If you choose to create a new domain configuration from the previous step, you will see the Create Domain Configuration page. In the Domain Configuration Properties section, choose Custom Domain, enter the information to create a domain configuration. If you choose to update an existing domain configuration for a custom domain, you will see the Domain Configuration Details page. Choose Edit. To enable OCSP server stapling, choose Enable Server Certificate OCSP Stapling in the Server Certificate Configuration subsection. Choose Create Domain Configuration or Update Domain Configuration. AWS IoT Core emits Retrieve OCSP Staple Data Success Metric and the Retrieve OCSP Staple Data Log Entries to CloudWatch. The metric and the log entries can help you detect issues related to retrieving OCSP responses. To recap, Online Certificate Status Protocol, or OCSP, is used to check the certificate revocation status during the transport layer security handshake. AWS IoT Core's OCSP stapling capability enhances security for your custom domains by continuously verifying server certificate validity. It improves privacy, reliability, scalability, and reduces latency compared to traditional client-side OCSP checks. To start using this feature, simply enable OCSP stapling when creating or editing a domain configuration for your custom domain in the AWS IoT console or through the CLI. To learn more about this feature, refer to AWS IoT Core Developer Guide. Useful links are provided in the description. Thanks for watching.